Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Dundalk TV's Nothing But the Truth special report. Yesterday, while I was online, I happened to see the Colorado school shooting, and the reporter was saying how the 20th anniversary of the Columbine shooting had just passed, and that the state of Colorado has had about a half a dozen school shootings since that time. Now, we also know that there has been many shootings nationwide in schools as well. And Einstein had said that the definition of insanity was doing the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. Now, that's what's happening here. We are doing the same thing over and over again, and we're not solving the problem. People keep telling us that we need to have gun-free zones, and they also want to tell us that guns are the problem, but that's not it. I think that it's a societal problem. We have kids learning about the violence at a very early age from TV and radio, and then they also are getting online to play games where you score points on killing people, so we have a really bad problem with that. And then on top of that, the school systems have such a big bullying problem, and the kids are not able to get the help that they need. So the kids that are being bullied can't get the help, and then the resources that are necessary to help the kids that have the problems, like Nicholas Cruz, look at what happened with him. The system totally dropped the ball with him. If they would have done something to help that situation out, there would have been no problem in the Parkland school. So the people that want to keep pushing this agenda have forgotten their history as well, because a current event that's just happening now is that the communist government in Venezuela has taken all the guns from their citizens, and now they're being slaughtered in the streets. So we do have a big problem in the school system that needs to be addressed, and that the biggest is bullying. And then from that is coming many suicides as well. So, and you're not going to hear many people talking about that, but that's a big issue that needs to be addressed as well. And another story that had happened the other day was Mary Bubala, who was anchorwoman for WJZ in Baltimore, was let go because she was discussing what was happening with Mayor Pugh and how she was resigning as the mayor of Baltimore City. Mary Bubala had asked a question about should we kind of change directions in Baltimore. She said that we've had three African-American women who have been the mayors of Baltimore City, and that the two of the mayors were actually resigned, and then Stephanie Rawlins Blake, who's famously said give them space to destroy, actually finished her term out but left in disgrace. So I think that this was a very fair and honest question, especially when most people are talking about this and asking those very same questions in Baltimore. And if we can't have an honest discussion, we won't be able to move forward at all. And someone had sent me this information about this in a video, and a guy had the video camera running on his TV screen, and then he was all upset when that question was asked. But many people have come out to defend Mary Bubala and said that she doesn't have a racist bone in her body. And I enjoyed watching her news coverage in the past, and I feel the same. I do not feel that it was a racist question at all. I feel that it was an honest question, and we need to have honest discussions. And that's why Dundalk TV is doing Nothing But the Truth. And I definitely don't feel that this had anything to do with race, because I want to tell you that Elijah Cummings doesn't do a good job. Neither does Anthony Brown. I don't feel that Obama did a good job, but that's politically. I'm speaking politically that they didn't do a good job. They just happened to, the color of their skin just happens to be black. I didn't like the job that Kevin Kamenetz did. I really don't like the job that Baltimore County Executive Johnny Osheski Jr. is doing right now. I didn't like the work that his father did. Dutch Riepersberger, total disgrace as far as I'm concerned. They all suck, and we need to be moving in a different direction. Boyd Rutherford, a gentleman of color, think that he does a great job with Governor Larry Hogan, looking to support him as he runs for governor. I actually encouraged somebody that is a person of color to run. I thought that they would be a good fit locally. And if Tyrone Keyes ever decides to run for office, I would support him. He's spot on, and he said about this incident that anybody that looked at this and thought that it was racially motivated was a fool, and I would have to agree with him. We also need to cut out the censorship. The censorship and not being able to have a honest discussion is killing us. So they call it political correctness. I call it BS, and we need to cut out the BS so we can move forward. Now, I'd like to thank everybody who has subscribed to Dundalk TV and watches our videos and shares our videos and also comments. We enjoy the comments, and please keep sharing the videos. And if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. We have a lot of good information that's going to be coming your way. We're doing a big crime report for Nothing But the Truth, and that's going to be out sometime soon. Have a wonderful day. I'm Scott Collier, and look forward to seeing you again online or on the street.